In our last episode, we talked about what could be the lowest priced EV in the US with the starting price that's expected to start from $25,000. These economically priced entry-level EVs will surely play a key role in Hyundai's plan to become a dominant force in the EV world, in its mission to sell 1.7 million EVs by the year 2026 on their way to becoming an exclusive EV maker, and become completely carbon neutral by 2045. However, as enticing as low-priced EVs that would have to sacrifice the range and the performance, consumers continue to demand longer driving, more sophisticated EVs. And Hyundai has an answer to the growing number of people that are becoming more demanding of the EVs that they purchase. In this episode of AutoVision, we will explore all the efforts that the Hyundai Motor Group is putting forth to deliver longer driving technology, to complement its benchmark, ultra-fast 800-volt charging technology. So, before we go on, we'd highly appreciate your support by subscribing, and turning on the notification bell, if you haven't already. And please don't forget to like, comment, and vote on the question that's presented at the end of the video. It's not a secret that the ultimate goal of every EV manufacturer in the world is to reach the elusive 500 miles or 800 kilometers in range. This is not because people actually have a need to drive 500 miles in a single excursion, but because of what's known as range anxiety. EV range anxiety is the fear of running out of power on a journey and not being able to find a charging point. It's a major stumbling block to greater EV adoption, and it has more to do with psychology than the actual range of EVs, or the availability of charging points. Psychological or not, it's a milestone that all EV manufacturers are trying to achieve from the marketing standpoint. However, from the standpoint of engineering, it's a figure that's also not easy to achieve by the current level of battery technology. The lithium-ion battery is the current top echelon technology that typically has an energy density of 300 to 350 watt-hours per kilogram, which typically translates to 500 to 600 kilometers in range. For this reason, a new class of technology must be utilized in order to extend the range to 800 kilometers. And most people in the industry would agree that a solid-state battery is a solution to this problem. Unlike lithium-ion batteries, solid-state batteries do not contain heavy liquid electrolytes. Instead, a solid electrolyte is used that can be in the form of glass, ceramics, or other solid materials. Without the need for a liquid, solid-state batteries can be much denser and compact, translating in more range. Also, solid-state batteries are much safer than conventional lithium-ion batteries, which use organic liquid electrolytes that are flammable and volatile. Solid-state batteries charge much faster as well, as they can reach an 80% charge within 15 minutes and incur less strain after multiple charging cycles. A lithium-ion battery will begin to degrade and lose power capacity after 1,000 cycles. On the other hand, a solid-state battery will maintain 90% of its capacity well after 5,000 cycles, and even up to high as 10,000 cycles. However, many obstacles lie ahead before the commercialization for the use in EVs can be realized. First, scaling up production to the level needed for usage in EVs remains an expensive endeavor. Solid-state batteries are nothing new, as the concept was invented in the 19th century, and its claim to fame as a smartwatch and a heartbeat regulator until now. Solid-state batteries are traditionally expensive to make, and employ manufacturing processes thought to be difficult to scale, requiring expensive equipment to produce. One example is vacuum deposition equipment, which deposit layers of material atom by atom or molecule by molecule on a solid surface, to alleviate the problem associated with its inherent flaw in its chemistry, which is that it can potentially degrade fast after a number of charge-discharge cycles, due to the accumulation of lithium dendrites, thin, tree-like pieces of lithium that branch out and can pierce the battery, thereby causing short circuits and other problems, rendering the battery unusable as the lithium metal anode is compromised. However, the use of multi-layer design employs the structure that places a less stable electrolyte sandwiched between more stable solid electrolytes, which prevents any lithium dendrite growth, making the multi-layer solid-state batteries hold 82% of their charge after 10,000 cycles, which is competitive with the lifetime of a fossil fuel-powered car. However, there are still many problems to be addressed, such as low temperature operations, as solid-state batteries historically have poor performance. As well, solid-state batteries are prone to breakage, as ceramic electrolytes require high pressure to maintain contact with the electrodes, and may break from mechanical stress. For all these reasons, commercialization is still years away, and the experts predict that it will be 2030 before it can be realized. The good news is, however, there is a stopgap measure that may bridge the gap between the traditional lithium battery and the solid-state battery. And that is the lithium metal battery, which is a hybrid of the traditional lithium-ion and solid-state battery. Hyundai has invested $100 million in SES, which is a spin-off of MIT based in Singapore. Originally called Solid Energy Systems, it changed its name because it decided that the production of 100% solid-state batteries wasn't practical due to the problems as explained previously. Instead, the company has pivoted to a hybrid battery, which means it combines solid and liquid components, specifically a protective anode polymer coating with a proprietary, highly concentrated solvent in salt-liquid electrolyte. This is because while solid electrolytes are best at preventing dendrite formation, they have their own flaws, which is manufacturability, as mentioned earlier. Despite using the liquid electrolytes, SES claims that its anode has an energy density of 417 watt-hours per kilogram, with the capacity of 107 amp-hours at room temperature, while capable of charging 10 to 90% in just 12 minutes. This means the hybrid battery is near solid state and can achieve the elusive 800 kilometer or 500 mile range, which is a huge breakthrough. In cooperation with the compatriot LG and SK that is also invested in the company, it's expected that the full commercialization of the hybrid lithium metal battery would be ready by 2025, with a production capacity of 1 gigawatt hour, just in time for the massive demand for batteries that would be required to meet Hyundai's sales target. The first Hyundai models to receive the newest lithium metal battery is the next generation Genesis model in the high-end Hyundai and Kia EVs, such as the GV90 electric SUV that is to share the large EGMP platform used on the production models based on the Kia Concept EV9 and the Hyundai 7 Concept, which is expected to have the battery capacity of 100 kWh. It will also power the next generation G80 and GV80 models, which will be converted to pure EVs based on Genesis's first proprietary electric platform. Instead of borrowing the EGMP platform, the Rimac-derived Genesis platform uses a T-shaped battery, and will be used on the next generation Genesis EVs, because EGMP has a limitation of 600 horsepower, and forces high vehicle height due to placement of battery on the floor, not ideal for sleek, low-slung sedans and coupes that Genesis hopes to produce. The expected release date of the all-new G80 and GV80 EVs will be in 2025, as Genesis is ceasing ICE products starting in 2025. The 800 kilometers or 500 mile range batteries would eventually trickle down to more mass market products like the IONQ 5 and the Kia EV6 as well eventually. However, the hybrid lithium metal battery is not without a shortcoming as it has a rather short lifetime. It can only offer 70% performance retention after 779 cycles and 90% retention in 550 cycles, compared to a conventional lithium ion battery's 1000 discharge cycles. This can be justified as the per charge energy density is greater, but it's a far cry from the full solid-state battery that has a lifespan of up to 10,000 cycles as mentioned previously. That's the reason why Hyundai is also investing in Massachusetts-based startup Factorial Energy, which claims its solid-state battery technology is safer than conventional lithium-ion technology, extends driving range by 20-50%, and is drop-in compatible for easy integration into existing lithium-ion battery manufacturing infrastructure. The company has also known to have solved the solid-state battery's inherent problem of not holding the capacity at room temperature, by its proprietary solid electrolyte to create cells with high voltage and high capacity electrodes, that enable a 40 amp-hour solid-state battery cell for EVs that works at room temperature. This is in addition to the investment the Hyundai has already made in conjunction with SK Innovation back in 2018 to acquire 4.26% of Colorado-based Solid Power, to produce all solid-state batteries that use the existing NCM or nickel, cobalt, manganese cathode materials used in lithium-ion batteries, and high-content silicon anode material. The resulting product would realize a target energy density of 930 watt-hours per liter or higher, which is approximately 33% higher performance than that of the current lithium-ion battery. Hyundai hopes that a prototype of the full solid-state battery is also introduced by 2025, and be ready for commercialization by 2030. Finally, Hyundai is partnering with IonQ, a leader in trapped ion quantum computing, to create better quality batteries by more precisely simulating and controlling their chemical reactions. This research has the potential to lead to new types of source material that save time, cost, and effort in the years to come. Quantum-powered chemistry simulation is expected to significantly enhance the quality of next-generation lithium batteries by making improvements to the device's charge and discharge cycles, as well as their durability, capacity, and safety. So in summary, Hyundai's effort seems relentless in its pursuit to become a leader in EVs, with a series of investments made towards improving the range of its electric vehicles, that would complement well its 800-volt ultra-fast charging platform that seems to be miles ahead of the competitors. As for the end of the video question, Which of the Hyundai model would benefit most from Hyundai's upcoming 800-kilometer or 500-mile range battery? Please vote and share your views by clicking on the link in the comments section below. Thanks for watching AutoVision, your best source for the fastest Korean car news and rumors. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe and click on the notification bell, as not to miss any of our new videos. It would help the channel greatly if you could view our videos as soon as they are uploaded, and watch them all the way until the end, which would help to reach more people. Also, to support our channel even further, please join our membership and enjoy the exclusive content and preview of the upcoming episodes. Finally, don't forget to join our forum and share your passion for Korean cars at koreancarnews.com. See you next time with the latest Korean car news.
Wake up, baby, all the stars are shining bright. Yeah, we should stay up so that we can look at them all night. Just keep holding me, don't let me go. Everything's so magical. All I need is you tonight. If I shut my eyes, keeping them closed, all the senses exposed.